Welcome back to the LNX Files. As always, this is a safe space for all things spooky. And today we're going to use these tarot cards to do a what the check on Leonardo DiCaprio and Eden Polani. Really? Teenagers? God, I hope not. So let's see. So, I feel like we can all collectively say that Leonardo DiCaprio has put us through a lot. I mean, I know I feel that way. You know, it's just like, this woman, that woman. So now we know that, who was it? So remember Victoria Llamas? Her and Leonardo DiCaprio were spotted together, you know, leaving together. And then her father was like blabbing to the tabloids. And then like, she obviously gave him the verbal lashing of his life and then we never heard about her again. Like, Leonardo DiCaprio is super private. And his people are very good at covering up his actions. So he was recently spotted abroad with Eden Polani. She's a very gorgeous, very young model. Eden Polani. She's also an Aries. So we can talk about that in a second. You know, beautiful girl, but teenagers, Leo? Like, teenagers? Is that what it's gonna take for you to, like, get aroused? Teenagers. So I when I read that headline, I got like a flash of the future. Like, what if he just starts going younger and younger just because like he's shagged so many beautiful women that the only way for a sense of novelty to come up for him would be, you know, to start shagging very young women. So I was just like, oh, great. So that was where my head went on this. Now, of course, his representatives, his publicists, his management, their job is just, you know, image protection, brand protection, and they're very good at it because in protecting him, they're protecting their own income as well and their livelihood and their legacy, right? So when they make an official statement saying they're not together, this is not happening, no, I mean, okay, all right. I mean, but we know that very likely things could be happening behind closed doors because, you know, a lot of times these celebrities have handlers and arrangers and fixers to get all the moving pieces into place. And I doubt that this would be his first teenager that he's ever shagged. I mean, let's get real. Like, he travels abroad all the time. So, and he was also noticeably quiet during the Me Too movement. You know, for somebody who is a connoisseur of beautiful women, you know, consenting beautiful women, he noticeably silent. You'd think he would have a lot of female friends he'd want to stick up for. Anyway, guess not. So before we start pulling cards on these two, one thing I wanted to say was that, as we know, I don't even need to pull this out, Leonardo DiCaprio, he's a Scorpio with a Libra rising and a Libra moon. And I did have a thought that, like, maybe that's one of the reasons why he is so preoccupied with models, beauty, and youth is because Venus has a very powerful place in his chart. So Venus is the ruler of Libra, which is where his rising sign is, and his moon. So that might have some accountability for his, like, severe fixation on youth and beauty and, you know, visual harmony. You know, or he's just, you know, he's just a dude, you know. So, yeah, let's start pulling some cards. So the first thing I want to ask is, have Leo and Eden hooked up? Will they continue seeing each other? So say they've hooked up. Will they continue seeing each other on the low? And by seeing each other, I mean either dating behind closed doors or hooking up behind closed doors. You know, you can hook up without dating on the regular. You can date without hooking up on the regular, but that wouldn't make any sense, right? Has Leo hooked up with other teenagers? And if the answer is yes, can you please give us a sense of how many? Why is Leo like this? I think that's a fair question. And is there anything else you want us to know about this situation? Because, my lord. All right. So, first off, have Eden and Leo hooked up? Oh, gosh. Interesting. Well, if we were to interpret this card literally... Oh, I just dropped it. We got the Three of Cups in reverse. So if we were to interpret this card literally, that would mean like a threesome gone wrong. Like, yeah, I mean, like, that's what that would indicate to me. So upright, this is a card of like, you know, it's not a romantic card. It's not a very sexual card. It can sometimes show up that way in readings, but it's, you know, it's rare. You know, it's just like love and abundance, creativity in groups. You know, it's like, oh, it comes up with coworkers, groups of friends. You know, there's a strong sense of platonicness in this card. So, I mean, when this card comes up in reverse, it can literally mean like that all those good things are draining out of the situation. Or it could also just mean like a subversion of the innocence of this card. So a subversion of like the platonic qualities, meaning like, you know, yes, there was hooking up, but there were other people involved, or maybe there were other people nearby, or like it was within the context of a party. But I would actually interpret this as a yes, even though with the cups cards for romantic questions, we often will interpret them in reverse as a no, meaning all the affection falling out of a situation. With this, I think because we're asking about a subject that's more subversive, it has a more subversive answer. Okay, will they continue seeing each other on the low? Oh, that's quite possibly. That's quite possibly. The Seven of Wands. So this is someone standing their ground against the crowd. So we're the crowd. We're the people, you know, clutching our pearls, just being like, oh my God, a teenager. But, you know, technically she's a legal adult. Like, she's not a minor person. So basically with this, this is a card of like, no, I'm going to do me. I'm going to do what I see as right. You know, you guys have your values. I'm going to do me. And Leonardo DiCaprio is very much that guy who's like, I'm going to do me, y'all. I mean, we have tisked at his like 25-year-old policy for the longest time. Yeah, so I mean, he's a billionaire movie star. Like, our like, who's gonna check this guy? Like, really? Have there been other teenagers that Leo has hooked up with? Why, yes. So we got the Ace of Cups, which is funny because like the ace is the beginning of the numerical suite aspect of the tarot. So like the first flush. So this to me loosely alludes to the youth and innocence of the people that he's hooked up with. So yes, that would be a hard yes. Yes, he has. Okay. All right. Why is he like this? Oh, interesting. Interesting. That's an interesting way of putting it. It's an interesting way of putting it. So we got the Six of Cups in reverse. So the Six of Cups upright, it's the Freaky Friday card. It's when like the older Jedi says to the younger Jedi, like, hey, I've walked in your shoes and I kind of get it now. Like, I get what it's like to be you. So this is not a romantic card. It's a card of compassion. And it's like having like the older folks having compassion for the younger folks, or just like having compassion for someone. Like, finally. So in reverse, this is a card where it's like, I don't get you, lack of compassion. And I think we can interpret this like two ways. So number one, it's a lack of compassion for like these young women and just how much he's running things and how vulnerable they are. Because like, I mean, the imbalance of power is like ridiculous. You know, a billionaire white boy celebrity like plucks you as like a 25-year-old. Like, for a regular 24-year-old to date a 48-year-old, big imbalance of power. It's kind of like they're calling the shots and getting away with everything. So there's that. There's the lack of compassion for these like young women and their vulnerability. But also what I'm getting is that the reason he has it was that there was a lack of compassion for him when he was a youth. Like, I've always had the pet theory that he was just one of the kids that was like abused when he was young in Hollywood, and that he was just really resilient, you know, because back then when he came up in the 80s, like, it was a very lawless time for children, and, you know, sets weren't well regulated, and he was probably surrounded by predators, and he's a really good looking kid. So the lack of compassion and safety that he felt as a youth is like sort of being projected and recycled onto these young women. Is there anything else you want us to know about the situation? Oh, I mean, that doesn't really tell us anything, but I mean, this doesn't really tell us anything. Like, we got the Three of Wands upright, so the situation's stabilizing. Someone's ships are gonna be coming in. I mean, what does this really mean? Like, the situation's stabilizing? Like, in what way? Like, I don't know. I mean, Three of Wands usually means a more stable situation, because with Three of Wands, you can build, like, you know, a stool, a desk, an ottoman, a little chair. So with this card, you know, it often means, like, your ships are finally coming in with goods and women and tales and spices. Sometimes it can have to do with, like, you know, situations with threes, like, two people here, one over here. Like, sometimes it can have to do with a side chick or side dude situation. But, I mean, I mean, with Leo, all bets are off. Like, even I'm like, I give up. I don't know. So if you have any thoughts about how to interpret this card, like the situation stabilizing, Leo doing more of the same, side chick situation, it could be all of those things. So if you have a theory of your own, put it in the comments. So that's what I've got for you guys. You know, do you have any problem with Leonardo DiCaprio dating a teenager? Let me know in the comments. Like and subscribe, and as always, we'll do this again.